this was an interesting challenge here in the Stewart Warner radio. First thing that we checked out was a transformer, and that proved to be a real problem. It was putting out a way too much voltage, and of course the damage that I saw from that originally, which I didn't fully understand until I checked the transformer, was a resistor that had actually exploded because of the high voltage that hit it. I estimated after I destroyed my meter on it that it was over 2,000 volts coming out of the transformer, and that was probably caused by the rare event of an active short between the layers of the coils of the primary, making the primary to secondary ratio too high. So we rewound the transformer and got it going properly. We've done a lot of capacitors. Every capacitor in it was actually bad. Some of the resistors were bad. It contains capacitors in boxes that are tar filled, which in those days was thought to be a way to make the capacitors last longer, sealing them from moisture and so forth. There's actually two tar boxes in that full of capacitors. I just disconnected them, didn't remove them or melt them out, and replaced them with modern capacitors underneath that should last for pretty well ever. Then, you know, we had all the usual problems with it, components here and there, a little bit of wiring. It had no tubes when it came, so I retubed it, and here we are. We have a very nice radio now, a 1929 radio that was produced in the early days of radio, and this one would have been really considered ultra-modern because in the days when television was a concept, the manufacturer put a television input on that, so you theoretically could listen to your television through your radio set. Didn't really work out over time, but you know, as a move in 1929, it would have been well advanced. And it has a feature on it that I like about this radio, in that it has two types of outputs for speakers, one to drive a magnetic speaker and one to drive a dynamic speaker. So it's quite versatile as far as that type of radio goes. Has a phono input too, and that. Unfortunately, it's all there except there's two lids missing. There's the lid that goes over the tuning capacitors is missing from it, and the lid over the radio is missing. But these are not critical to the operation of the radio. They're not shields or anything, but just covers. And you know, who knows, maybe someday we'll come across a lid or make one or something for it. But as it stands right now, it's a beautiful radio. It works really well, and it should last a long time. Actually cut down to two radios, so I could concentrate on this. Winding the transformer is a little slow process. It took me a couple of hours a night for two nights, I think, to do that. I unwound the transformer and count the windings in it to see what the ratios were and how that particular transformer worked, and to see if I could find the fault in it, which I didn't find. So I just came to the conclusion that it was an active short rather than a passive short, where voltage was breaking down through insulation. There was no really arcing points or flash points I could see. But, I do so much with this radio, then I do so much more with the next one and the next one and the next one, and then I'll paint something and I'll wait for that to dry and I'll come back to this one and so forth. It just continues on. It's a good many hours went into it. There's a difference between repairing a radio, making it work, and restoring radio so it will keep working. And that's mainly what I do. I want to have this keep on going for a long time. To get it, to fix it, to make it work, is very short, quick work. But it's restored now. And in this box here are six capacitors and two filter chokes, and this would be considered the filter bypass capacitor block. Underneath this cover here is the rectifier tube and the line regulating resistor. This one here is the transformer, and these other boxes here, four of these are actually small transformers, and they're RF transformers, and they couple the signal in at the RF level throughout the radio. This is what you call a tuned radio frequency radio. It's not a super heterodyne, it's a TRF. And these are the decoupling coils here. And these here are your coupling transformers, audio coupling transformers, these two boxes here. Also, underneath the tuning capacitor here is another tire box with the filter capacitors in it. It is actually the size of this filter, the size of this tuning capacitor, but it contains only two capacitors, which I replaced with modern ones, which are probably less than 5% of the size of the originals. And the tubes are shielded. These four tubes here are shielded in order to prevent tubes from oscillating into one another and coupling against one another and picking up extraneous noises. So these ones are the RF tubes, and they are shielded. So there they are.